Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we have seen that what is ROM, and we have also seen the different types of ROM. And we understood that how the ROM is used for storing the permanent data in the instruction in the different applications. But apart from storing the data, it can also be used as a programmable logic device. So first of all, let us understand what is PLD or the programmable logic device. And then we will see that how the ROM can be used as a programmable logic device. So this programmable logic device or this PLD is a chip or the integrated circuit that can be programmed to perform the variety of digital logic functions. So if you see the conventional logic IC, for example decoder IC or the adder circuit IC, then it can perform only the specific task. And the logic function that is performed by this IC cannot be changed. For example, this adder circuit IC can only perform the addition of the two numbers. But using this, it is not possible to perform the any other logic function. On the other end, if you see the PLD, then as its name suggests, they are the programmable. That means they can be reprogrammed to perform the different logic functions. So the same IC can be used to perform the addition of the two numbers, as well as it can also perform the binary to gray code conversion. So in general, it can be reprogrammed to perform the any logic function. So there are different types of programmable logic device like the PL, PLA, CPLD and the FPGA. And even this programmable ROM can also be used as a programmable logic device. So if you see the combinational PLDs, then they consist of the array of the AND gates and the OR gates. And the interconnections between them can be programmable. For example, in these PLDs, the interconnection between the inputs and the AND gate can be fixed or the programmable. Likewise, the interconnection between the AND gate array and this OR gate array can be fixed or the programmable. And by programming these interconnections between the AND gate and the OR gate array, it is possible to implement the different logic functions. So earlier we have seen that the output of any combinational logic circuit can be expressed in the sum of product form. For example, the given logic circuit is the full adder circuit. So here, the sum output of the circuit can be given by this expression. And the carry output can be given by this expression. So in the sum output, if you see all the terms, then it is the product of the individual variables. So with the help of the AND gate, it is possible to get these different terms. And this plus sign represents the sum of these different product terms. So with the help of the OR gates, it is possible to perform the sum operation. And the same thing is also true for this carry output. That means with the help of the AND gate and the OR gate array, it is possible to represent the output of any logic circuit in the sum of product form. So in this programmable ROMs, this AND gate array is the fixed one, while the OR gate array is the programmable. So let us understand that with the help of the 8x4 ROM. So if you see any programmable ROM, then it consists of the decoder and the memory cells. And these memory cells are formed by making the interconnections between the output of the decoder and the OR gates. So in this 8x4 PROM, we have total 8 words. So to address these words, we will require the 3 to 8 decoder. And this is the internal circuit of the decoder. So as you can see, this 3 to 8 decoder consists of the 8 AND gates. And each AND gate represents the specific minterm. So as you can see in this decoder, the interconnections between the input and the AND gates are fixed. That means here, these interconnections between the input and the AND gate are not programmable. So we can say that this decoder will act as a fixed array of the AND gates. But if you see the interconnections between the output of the decoder and the OR gate, then they are the programmable. That means by applying a high voltage to the specific pin in the PROM, the programmer can remove some of the interconnections. So here, in this 8x4 PROM, the each OR gate consists of the 8 inputs. So if you see the first OR gate, or this D3 output, then here, out of the 8 possible inputs, only 5 inputs are connected to the OR gate. So here, the each output of the decoder represents the specific minterm. That means here, the first output represents the minterm M0, while the second output, that is labeled as a 1, represents the minterm M1. So here, the output of the decoder corresponding to the minterm M0, M2, M3, M4 and the M6 are connected to this first OR gate. That means the output of the first OR gate is the summation of all these minterms. So here, in this 8x4 PROM, the each output of the OR gate represents the specific Boolean function of the three variables. Similarly, if you see the output of the second OR gate or this D2 output, then it is the summation of the 6 minterms. Likewise, this D1 is the summation of this minterm M0, M2, M3, M5 and the M6. And likewise, this D0 is the summation of the 5 minterms. That means here, using this 8x4 PROM, we can implement the 4 different functions of the 3 variables. So suppose, if we have a 16x4 ROM, then we can implement the 4 different functions of the 4 variables. But suppose, instead of the 16x4, if we have a 16x8 ROM, then we can implement the 8 different functions of the 4 variables. So let us take one example and let us see how to implement this full adder and the full subtractor circuit with the help of this 8x4 PROM. So we know that the full adder circuit consists of the 2 outputs, that is the sum and the carry output. And similarly, this full subtractor circuit also consists of the 2 outputs, that is the difference and the borrow output. So in total, we will require total 4 outputs. And as you know, both full adder and the full subtractor circuit consist of total 3 inputs. That means using the 8x4 ROM, it is possible to implement this circuit. So earlier, we have already covered the full adder and the full subtractor circuit. And as per that, this is the truth table of the full adder circuit. So as you can see in this truth table, the sum output is 1 for the 4 different minterms. That is minterm M1, M2, M4 and the M7. Similarly, this carry output is also 1 for the 4 different minterms. That is equal to minterm M3, M5, M6 and the M7. So in this way, we got the expression of the sum and the carry output of the full adder in the SOP form. So similarly, let us find the expression of the full subtractor. So earlier, we have also covered the full subtractor circuit. And as per that, this is the truth table of the full subtractor. So as you can see over here, this difference output is equal to 1 for the 4 different minterms. That is minterm M1, M2, M4 and the M7. And likewise, if you see this borrow output, then it is also equal to 1 for the 4 different minterms. That is minterm M1, M2, M3 and the M7. So in this way, these are the expressions of the difference and the borrow output for the subtractor in the SOP form. So in this way, we got the 2 expressions for the full subtractor and the 2 expressions for the full adder. So if you see the first expression for the difference output, then it consists of the 4 minterms. So in the first OR gate, using the programming, we can make the interconnections corresponding to these 4 minterms. Similarly, in the second OR gate, we need to make the 4 interconnections, that is M1, M2, M3 and the M7. That means now, the output of the second OR gate represents the borrow output. And similarly, the output of the first OR gate represents the difference output. And likewise, these are the corresponding interconnections for the sum and the carry output. So in this way, it is possible to implement the full adder and the full subtractor circuit using this 8x4 ROM. So corresponding to the given interconnections, this is the content of the each word in the ROM. Or in other words, this is the truth table of the ROM. So by programming the ROM according to this truth table, it is possible to implement the full adder and the full subtractor circuit. So similarly, if you want to implement the multi-output functions, then it can be easily implemented using this PROM. For example, if you want to implement the binary to gray code converter, then it can be easily implemented using this PROM. So as you know, this binary to gray code converter takes the n bit binary number as an input and it gives the n bit gray code as an output. So if you want to implement the 3 bit binary to gray code converter, then using this 8x4 ROM it can be easily implemented. Because as you know, this 8x4 PROM consist of the 3 inputs and the 4 outputs. So here, using the 3 address inputs and using any of the 3 OR gate outputs, it is possible to implement the code converter. So let's say the 3 bit binary number is equal to B2, B1, B0, where the B2 is the MSB and this B0 is the LSB. So similarly, the corresponding gray code is G2, G1, G0. So in one of the earlier videos, you have already seen that how to perform the binary to gray code conversion. So we have seen that during the conversion, this MSB G2 is same as the B2. Then after, the G1 bit in the gray code is equal to B2 XOR B1. That means by performing the XOR operation between this B2 and B1, we will get the G1 bit of the gray code. And likewise, this G0 is equal to B1 XOR B0. So these are the 3-bit gray codes corresponding to the 3-bit binary numbers. So as you can see over here, we have total 3 outputs, that is G2, G1 and the G0. So if you see this G2 output, then it is equal to 1 for the 4 different input combinations. Or in other words, this G2 output is equal to 1 for the 4 different minterms. That is minterm M4, M5, M6 and the M7. That means in the SOP form, this is the expression of the G2. Similarly, this output G1 is also 1 for these 4 different minterms. That is minterm M2, M3, M4 and the M5. And likewise, this G0 output is also equal to 1 for these 4 minterms. So in this way, we got the expression of the G2, G1 and the G0 in terms of the binary inputs B2, B1 and the B0. So now, these 3 functions can be implemented using the 8x4 PROM. So here, the 3 binary inputs are applied to the address inputs of this ROM. That means here, the binary inputs B2, B1 and B0 are applied to these address inputs. And here, out of the 4 outputs, only 3 outputs, that is D2, D1 and D0 are used. So here, for this G2 output, these 4 different interconnections, that is 4, 5, 6 and 7 are connected with the OR gate. Similarly for the G1, these outputs 2, 3, 4 and 5 are connected with the OR gate. And similarly for the G0, these outputs 1, 2, 5 and 6 of the decoder are connected with the OR gate. And in this way, it is possible to implement the binary to gray code converter using the PROM. So in general, we can implement any logic function using this PROM. So just to understand it more clearly, let us take one more example. So let's say, we want to design a circuit which will accept the 3-bit binary number as an input, and in response, it will generate the square of the binary input. So here, for the 3-bit binary number, we have total 8 different possibilities, that is from 0 to 7. And if you see the next column, then it shows the corresponding square of the number in the decimal. So here, when the input is 0, then the square of that number is 0. And similarly, when the input is 7, then the square of the number is equal to 49. So the columns just after that shows the equivalent binary numbers corresponding to these decimal numbers. So as you can see over here, in this case, the maximum number that we will get as an output is equal to 49. And to represent that, here we will require at least 6 bits. So here, this D5 to D0 are the 6 outputs of the circuit. So if we want to implement this circuit with the help of the PROM, then we at least require the 6 outputs. Or in other words, we will require at least 8x6 PROM. But as you know, typically, these PROMs are available in the multiple of 4 bits. That means here, to implement this function, we will require at least 8x8 PROM. But if you closely observe, then here, this D0 output always remains 0. Similarly, if you see this D0 output, then it is same as the LSB of the input. That means here, we only need to program the 4 outputs. And that is why it is possible to implement this circuit using the 8x4 PROM. So here, the 4 outputs of the ROM will represent the D5, D4, D3 and the D2. So if you see this D5 output, then it is equal to 1 for the 2 minterms, that is minterm M5 and the M6. That means here, this first OR gate represents the D5 output. Similarly, if you see the D4 output, then it is equal to 1 for the 3 different minterms, that is minterm M4, M5 and the M7. So after these interconnections, the second OR gate will represent the D4 output. Likewise, this D3 output is equal to 1 for the 2 different minterms, that is M3 and the M5. And similarly, this D2 is also 1 for the 2 different minterms, that is M2 and the M6. So by making these interconnections, we will get the outputs D5, D4, D3 and the D2. So now let us see how to get this D1 and the D0 outputs. So as you can see from the truth table, this D1 always remains 0. That means here, this D1 can be permanently connected to the logic 0. And likewise, if you see the D0 output, then it is same as the LSB of the input. That means here, this D0 line can be connected to the LSB of the input. So in this way, using the 8x4 ROM, it is possible to implement this circuit. So in short, in this way, this PROM can be used as a programmable logic device. And by reprogramming this ROM, it is possible to implement the different logic functions. So in the next video, we will see the other programmable logic devices like the PL and the PLA. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.